Hi, this is Darlene from Digital Photo Mentor. Welcome to day two of our 7-day photo editing challenge. Today, we're going to be working on a portrait image. If you haven't already signed up for the challenge and are receiving the email so you can download the files to follow along, make sure that you sign up using the link below the video. So without further ado, let's get started and open this image up in Luminar. So I've already done a little bit of basic editing on this photo to go along with the tips that I gave you yesterday on day one. So I'll just give you a short before and after. So that's what the image looked like straight out of camera. This is a raw file from my Fuji camera on my recent trip last April, our photography tour to Vietnam. And this was one of our lovely models that we had one day. So that's what the image looked like straight out of camera. And that's what I've done with it so far. So I've just kind of brought the shadows up a little bit, brought the highlights down a little bit, brought some details out and added an edge vignette. So those are the basic edits that are done. So what I really want to show you in this video is the power of the portrait AI and the portrait tools built into Luminar 4. So you can do the same kinds of editing in Photoshop or Lightroom, but it will take you a lot longer and it's much harder. So initially I was resistant to the idea of AI or artificial intelligence and letting the program do things automatically for me. But let me show you firsthand real time how it works, and then I'll let you decide for yourself because I think it's fantastic. So the first thing that I'm going to do is open up the portrait tab on the right here. And the first tool that we have is the skin AI skin enhancer. So I'm going to turn on, I'm going to click this little box to turn on the skin defects removal. Now I'm going to go ahead and put this slider pretty much all the way to the right. I'm going to click over here about 90% or so that you can see what's happening and what it's doing immediately. All right, let me do a before and after again. Now really take close attention to her face. I'm going to zoom in a little bit for you. Okay, so what's happening is it's analyzing the image. Luminar is analyzing the image using its algorithms and special science in the background. I don't profess to understand how it does this, but it's analyzing the image to figure out where the face is and where her skin is and applying the enhancer. But look what it's done. Let's take another look at the before and after. Okay, let's look at the slider method. Okay, look what it's done. Right? She's got quite a few blemishes and imperfections in her skin, and it smoothed them out really nicely. It's done a super nice job. It's missed maybe two or three small ones, which is not bad at all. But what else it's done is it's left the texture of her skin. So I've seen a lot, I'm just gonna zoom in to extreme here to 100%. You never wanna look at yourself in the mirror at this degree, trust me. But look at what's happening. You can still see her pores, right? And you can still see the texture and her eyebrows and her eyelashes. So it hasn't eliminated the texture and what's underneath there. So it's just eliminated the blemishes. It's really amazing. Okay, so I'm going to zoom back out to 50% and turn this guy off. So let me turn it down a little bit. So like I mentioned in the video yesterday, you want to kind of go to extremes with your retouching and then bring it back to somewhere in the middle. So almost never do I want to use any of the sliders at 100%. I'm going to scale this one back to about 60, right? And it does a really nice job, but still leaves maybe a little couple of blemishes without overdoing the skin softening. And if that's too much for you, bring it back to, 50 or 40, wherever is comfortable for you. You get to decide, right? Full range of slider. So that's the first one. Now we're going to move on to the portrait enhancer tools and all of the lovely sliders that are in here. Okay, so I'm just going to go through them one by one. So face light is going to obviously analyze and light her face. Now I played around a little bit with this one and I think I want to light her up maybe about 20 or so. Red eye, we don't have any, so I'm going to leave that one. Eye whitening, you have to be really careful with eye whitening on this slider that you don't go too far, because anytime you're whitening the eyes, you get that danger of overdoing it. Okay, so before and after. You can see the whites of her eyes, and I think it's gone a little too far, so I'm going to scale it back to about 50 and see what that looks like. Let's see how that goes. Okay, the next slider is the eye enhancer. So it's actually finding the iris and sharpening it up. So I'm going to go sort of, I don't know, I like 25-30% sort of as a nice adding a little enhancement without going too far. Dark circle removal, again, I could go all the way if you want to see what it does all the way. And I encourage you to play with these sliders and take them to the extremes, see what it looks like. Kind of starts to look a little bit overdone, like I said, and then bring it back to somewhere a bit more natural. Okay, one of my big pet peeves about any type of portrait retouching is that it's overdone. So I definitely don't want to overdo it and make her not look like a real person or like herself anymore. So these next two, so I'm going to scale that one back as well. These next two, again, I thought I would never use these. It's not something that I generally do on portraits, is to change the shape of someone's face. But in this case, I've done enlarge eyes up to about 30%. Let's see how that looks. And what happens is, because she's kind of squinting and she's looking down, it actually helps to make her eyes look more open. Let's see how that looks. Right? Look at her eyes. It's pretty amazing, right? It just looks like she's kind of doing a squint, right? So I'm going to do a slim face as well. Now, the more things you add, the more time it's going to sort of take to process in the background, because there's a lot going on here under the hood. So just have patience until the program catches up. But it works pretty well, and I'm showing this to you real time, okay? Now, this one, I'm gonna take it to extreme just to show you what it looks like again, and then we'll bring it back, because I would never do this to this girl. It's changing how she looks completely. So once again, let's take a look at the before and after. So look at how extreme. It's slimming her face and enlarging her eyes with those two sliders. And I would not go this far. I would generally tend to keep this slim face one down under 20. I might want to do it just ever so slightly. You know, people smile and their cheeks get kind of puffy and it makes their face look rounder, just to tuck it in ever so slightly, but be very, very subtle with these two. I encourage you to be very subtle, right? Eyebrow improve is going to darken and enhance the contrast and clarity on the eyebrows. And then we have lips and teeth. So I'm going to do teeth whitening. I'm going to darken her lips a little bit. I don't want to go too saturated, because she looks like she's got like natural makeup, and I don't want to overdo it and make her look like she's wearing a ton of makeup, right? That looks pretty nice. Okay, one more before and after. So it was really dark, brought out the details in the background, but look at her face and look at what these sliders are doing, right? I have not touched a brush here. Keep that in mind, okay? I've not touched a brush. So if you struggle with portrait editing, masking, or doing things that are complicated in Photoshop, like frequency separation, or even understanding what that is, this might be just the thing for you, okay? So as I mentioned, you can do these things in Lightroom as well, but you're going to be using cloning, you're going to be using adjustment brush on different parts of the face, different kinds of adjustment brushes. I have a video actually where I've demonstrated portrait editing in Lightroom, and I'll put a link below the video for you if you want to check that one out and just see the comparison. So if you're using Lightroom, you can see how much longer it takes to do it with Lightroom than to do it in Luminar. So I'm going to add one more thing, and that is an Orton effect. Okay, so an Orton effect is kind of a softening filter. Back in the days of film, you actually sandwiched two pieces of film together, one that was shot out of focus and one that was shot in focus, and it made a really kind of interesting effect. And the guy that created it, his name was Orton, so they named it after him. Go figure. So what it's doing here is giving her another sort of nice softening glow on her face. It's actually applying to the whole image. So if I wanted to, I could mask it out and have it not apply on the background or her hair and so on. But in the essence of time and demonstration, I'm just going to have it apply to the whole image for this example. Okay, so see how it's adding a really nice softening, and it kind of takes away it was a really hot day when we photographed this and she was quite sweaty and her skin was oily. So it kind of takes away that look of being oily or greasy, right? If somebody's got really greasy skin, generally if you have that, you have to do a lot of brush editing. Okay, so really quickly, I'm just going to back out to fit the whole image. Okay, so you can see before and after. It's done a very, very nice job. All right, so I'm going to do a couple of last things here. I'm going to crop the image a little bit. So that's up in the pencil and ruler up here in the canvas. So I'm going to crop, choosing the crop tool. And I'm going to keep the aspect ratio, and I want to kind of come in and put her a little more off center. So she's in the third, and I'm actually going to apply a little bit of a tilt, and it's going to kind of crop off part of her head, but I don't mind that. Okay, so now her face is more in the rule of thirds, and she's a bit more off center, and I like that composition a little bit better, and her shoulders aren't as square on. Okay. Finally, I'm going to do one last thing. So I'm going to zoom into 100% here just to show you that, yes, there's a couple of blemishes that the software has missed. We have to wait for it to catch up because I've just applied a lot of editing. Okay, so you can see there's a little blemish on her lip here, maybe one on her cheek, and then a couple of things on her forehead that maybe the AI didn't get, but it's done pretty well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back into my canvas, and I'm going to use the erase tool. So if you're used to using Photoshop or Lightroom or Adobe products, erase is like the healing tool that you would expect to find in an Adobe product. Okay, so erase is going to help me literally erase those blemishes. Okay, so now when the tool is opened, it's pretty straightforward. So it starts with the setting of add, okay, right up here, but you can subtract. So let's say I want to add a dot. So I want to take away these couple of dots on her forehead. You just start clicking, and you can do more, like there's a hair here on her forehead. So I might try to get rid of that, some sort of weird hair, okay? And then you just click erase, and it does the job for you, okay? So you'll see the spots disappear, and then you're ready to go again, right? So that did a pretty good job. And let's do a couple of more spots. This little white dot here. Just give her a little bit smoother skin. Let's see how it does with this. So it did a nice job on the hair. Now let's see how it does up there, because that one is in her hair. So let's see how it handles the hair. Not too bad. It looks like it removed a little bit of the hair, but when you zoom out, I don't even think we're going to notice that. Okay, a couple more. Let's do this one down here. I think that's pretty good. I'm just looking for sort of dots that I can get rid of. Now this one over here is kind of on the edge of her cheek. Let's see how it does there. Oh, nice job. Okay, so now when we're ready, we just hit done to apply it. And we're back into regular editing mode. I'm gonna go fit it on the screen again. Now, the one thing that I will mention is that if you're going to use the eraser tool, make sure, or the cloning stamp tool, make sure that you do it last. Because what it's done is, you can see I'm in the layers mode here, panel, you can see that it's actually added a layer. So if I go back to the base layer and do any editing on the image again from the base layer, it's actually not going to apply. It's not going to show through because the erase layer is on top. Okay, so if you're doing any cloning, make sure you leave that till the end and you do that last, kind of as what's called a stamped layer, so that all of your edits apply in with the cloning and the erasing. So one more time, before and after. And you saw me do nothing with the paintbrush, maybe 8 or so spots with the cloning and erasing tool, and that's it. So if you take people pictures and you enjoy doing any kind of people photography where you want to enhance the face a little bit without looking like plastic mannequins, this is a great tool. So I encourage you to give Luminar 4 a try, especially the portrait AI, and we'll see you in the next video tomorrow. Okay, so we're back in the regular canvas now that the cloning has been applied. And one final thing, I'll just mention that if you're going to do any cloning or erasing or stamping, make sure that you do it last, because it actually comes up as a new layer on top of your other edits. So if you do anything to your base layer, it's kind of going to be hidden underneath and it won't apply. So make sure you do your cloning and healing last. right? Or you make what's called a stamp layer right here, right? Which will then have all the layers combined into one, and you can continue editing if you want to keep going. But I'm happy with that. So I hope you enjoyed this little demonstration of Luminar 4 Portrait AI. I'll be back tomorrow with another video tutorial and another image for you to practice with. Take care, and we'll see you then.